When I say I'm not a politician is I talk straight, whether people like it or not, as long as I want. I'm not talking about you. Yossi, you gave such a good speech. You should be a politician. You should be running for office. One thing that you did not hit, and we saw it last week, and I'll reach out to our chairman. Mamandi's Medical Center is building a new building. And before we talk about banks and other people, Mamandi's Medical Center lives off us, they work from us, they kill the neighborhood, and there's no reason a hospital like this should be up over here without a lot of people working. We can get jobs over there. We can do the plumbing jobs over there. We can do the electrical jobs. We can do the painting jobs. We can do everything in there. There's no reason a man of this hospital comes in. And all these stories that they keep on telling, that our people are not educated, let them come to OJPC and tell us. Bring us radiologists. Bring us nurses. We at OJPC will go out, we'll create a program to educate these people as long as they promise us jobs as soon as these people graduated. Let them stop with these stories of telling us that we're not educated people. We have lawyers, we have doctors, we have accountants, we have everything in the world, and we can get any job that they want within a few months. Concerning Noah's deal or any other thing, I'd like to explain for people what's happening over here and how a person gets elected. Many ask me that this place should not be a platform, but I'd like to announce that next week, Monday, in my offices, people know my office. If they don't know my office, we will give out the address. I will have a meeting. I'm exploring the position of running for district leader of the Assembly District 48. This is not over here to discuss. Anybody that wants to come out and discuss it with me afterwards on this coming Monday. The people that go on the ballots on the election have to have the support of the district leaders. They have to go out and they have to nominate a judge to be on the ballot. There's a petition process, people have to go and take signatures. Afterwards, the county committee comes out and signs and it says who it is. We all know that New York City is a Democratic city. Basically, it means that the Democratic Party will go out and they will decide who could get their line. Once you get their line, you're basically guaranteed to win that seat. It's not even an election. Once in a while, there's a primary. In order to get it, there's about 21 district leaders that have to go out and vote. Now let's talk frankly what's happening over here. The district leader over here in this district at 48, his name is Don Hiking. We're not going to go on a personal level, but we all know that he had some issues going back with Noah's deal while he was around. He continues to have these issues right now with our current councilman, but we're not going to discuss that particular issue. But he does not want to go out and fight for Noah's deal for whatever reason it is. He will vote for Noyerti, he claims that he will vote for Noyerti, but he would go out and really discuss with other district leaders. He could come and bring on board a couple of district leaders. Why is it important? We all know what Noyerti did the last years to help people. Everybody knows the stories with the credit cards and the banks, whatever he helped. If a guy like him wants help, I don't know if it's the right thing, I don't understand, I've never been in the judicial system if what he does is the right thing. But there's no question that people that work in our community, people that represent our community, should do what other people have done. If we should call out on the street to find out how many people might have been helped in the last year, there would be thousands of people. And if a guy helped, you have to come out and make sure that you help that guy back. According to our previous claims, that he's not going to be able to move up, he's going to completely retire. I don't know exactly the situation. But we need district leaders that will come out and will put away their petty views in what is involved in their personal political game and come and really help the community. To elaborate what Yossi said originally, we look back there's 20 years or 30 years in politics, and I'm happy that it worked out, because the truth of the matter is like this. Jongens en gauw een schrok. There's no ideas, I don't know how long. Don't mind him, this I don't know how long. That was some geweldig. We needed a state senate seat being recycled, and then he's back again. Now we need again Northfield, he's up again, hopefully he's coming out again. And then the Greenfield is basically guaranteed until he's turned up and out. We don't have young people, we don't have a variety of people involved in politics. The reason why it's so important to be involved in politics is very simple. Everybody could go out and give some money for most of the United States to give more money, you could give a building, you could help, but you could help with a limit. When you go in and you tap into city and state resources that are out over there to help the people come out of poverty, as he claimed, to bring in a little bit of affordable housing. Now, people have said for the last 30 years that affordable housing could only be built in the Bronx. You look around what Peter Lopez did in his area. I can give you addresses in New York City that they built affordable housing. Imagine the guy with the city over here is not ready to announce, but he's working on a property in Florida with all the city and state agencies that it's working affordable over here, it just takes time. There is no reason for that. People ask me, isn't there a reason? Doesn't our politicians want to help the community? The answer is, of course they want to help the community. But they want to help their easy way. They're looking for votes, and they're looking for people out there that can deliver them the votes. Our big yeshivas and organizations, there's a boilerplate that we need it. They need all kinds of help that they could get for the yeshiva in the schools, because we don't get our fair share. Now, when these people come back to politicians, they tell them, listen, we will give you our votes if you help us with this program. If you help us with this, the politician will do everything that they need. The little guy's voice is not being heard, whether it's the jobs, or the apartment, or the creation, or the banks are opening. They're not being heard because we're not organized. And individually, we should have to go out and reach out to 1,000 people individually. It's much more easier to go to the few big cables, to the few big voices. You guarantee the X amount of votes and you come out. The way that we could make a difference and deliver that everything that Yossi does and go out and help them is being involved in the political process. Petition time starts next week. If we could get people out to collect petitions for whomever it is, everybody needs petitions. You can go out and collect petitions for Simchat Feldman. As long as he will know that if we come over here and we collect for him 1,000 petitions, he will look at us and he will say, you know what? This is a group of dedicated people that let me sit with them down after the elections and work with him. You go out and you collect petitions for a statewide office. The county will turn around and they will say, you know what? These are people that we could use. Let us hear what they need. Our demands from the government is much more easier than the advocates that work for the schools. The advocates that work for the schools is a very important job, but they have to be creative how you could be helped with not to interfere with the state and say separation of state and church. What we're demanding is things that we could get very easy. Our voices are not heard because still not everybody, the only organized people are the people that meet for their schools. Once we'll get organized and we'll show people what we could do, we will succeed because they need votes and they need help. We're going to leave over here a piece of paper. Everybody that is ready to help this idea of helping other people take petitions to be able to make this work should leave their name and number. We're going to have to go out, meet the district leaders, help them financially, create fundraisers, which we have to get people for money, but besides people for money, we need people to show that we're a power. And by doing that, we will be able to help everybody. Thank you very much.